Powdery mildew on grapevines, also known as Oidium, is a serious fungal disease that affects all green parts of the plant. The first symptoms can appear early in the growing season, as the young shoots begin to emerge. On the leaves, especially on the upper side, grayish-white spots with a spore-bearing coating are observed. In cases of heavy infestation, the leaves become deformed, burn, and dry out. On the shoots, watery spots with a whitish coating appear at first, which then merge and form dark brown to violet brown streaks. These streaks remain visible on the canes until the following year. The disease spreads through infected cuttings and rootstocks. On the flower clusters, the fungus causes poor fruit set, deformation, and burning. However, the most typical symptoms are seen on the berries, especially from the fruit set stage to the veraison stage. Small spots covered with a whitish coating initially form, which later becomes grayish-white. The affected tissues harden, the berries crack, seeds become exposed, and juice starts to leak. In severe cases, entire clusters become covered with mildew, emitting a distinctive smell of rotten fish. After the veraison stage, the fruit is no longer susceptible to the disease. The pathogen is the fungus erysiphe nicator, SIN. Uncinula nicator. It overwinters as mycelium under the bud scales and in the bark of shoots. In spring, the mycelium begins developing at temperatures of 5 to 6 degrees Celsius, infecting young shoots. The disease develops best at temperatures between 25 to 28 degrees Celsius and relative air humidity between 60 to 80%. The incubation period varies, about 25 days at 8 degrees Celsius and only 7 days at 24 to 25 degrees Celsius. A unique characteristic of this fungus is that it does not require free water to germinate. In fact, water droplets can hinder the infection process. Heavy rains limit the disease's development by washing spores, conidia, into the soil. Among desert grape varieties, the most susceptible to powdery mildew are Brestovitza, Bulgar, Italia, and Cardinal. Among wine varieties, Rucuzzitelli, Sauvignon Blanc, Cabernet Sauvignon, and Merlot are highly sensitive. Moderately sensitive varieties include Pamid, Muscat Autonal, and Chardonnay. More resistant varieties include Regent, Solaris, Johanniter, Arcadia, and some newly bred hybrids like Pleven, Burley Rosensky, Super Early Bulgar, and Kalina. These are especially suitable for organic viticulture and regions with high humidity. Grapevines should be cultivated in well-ventilated areas with proper row orientation. Applying green pruning practices such as shoot thinning, pinching, and lateral shoot removal is essential to reduce humidity and improve air circulation within the canopy. For disease control, 1 to 2 pre-bloom sprays are recommended, with the first one carried out when the shoots are 10 to 12 centimeters long. After that, another 2 to 3 post-bloom treatments are needed, depending on the variety's sensitivity and weather conditions. The interval between sprays should be 10 to 14 days. There are many registered fungicides for powdery mildew control, both contact and systemic. Products with active ingredients such as sulfur, myclobutanil, tetraconazole, tebuconazole, flupyrim, pyroclostrobin, penconazole, spiroxamine, and ciprodenil have shown high efficacy. For best results, rotate products with different modes of action to avoid resistance development. Biopesticides based on potassium bicarbonate, neem oil, or mycelial extracts can also be effective in low to moderate infections. I will share links to the products I have personally found most effective in my vineyard experience. It is crucial to observe the pre-harvest intervals for all applied products, especially in desert grape varieties intended for fresh consumption. Additionally, it is important to note that powdery mildew can have serious economic impact, reducing both the yield and quality of grapes, negatively affecting aroma and taste in wines, and making fresh market grapes unmarketable. For more tips and practical guidance, check out my videos on green pruning and vine protection during the growing season.